Let's look at some postings in the CEO module. Let's look at adjustment postings. At the time of a financial posting, let's say you have used an incorrect GL account. Instead of using the salaries expense account, maybe you would have used the building rental expense account. And you have posted the transaction. Now, if you want to do a change for that, you have to reverse that document and repost it. There's no other way of doing it. So, if you have used a primary cost element, which is one of the main components of the financial postings, or like you have used incorrect company code, another main component of the financial posting, you have to reverse that document and repost it with the correct entry. But let's say when you have entered all the relevant information, the financial information, and you have used an incorrect cost center. Instead of using the cars production cost center, you have used the vans production cost center. Then you can do a manual reposting. So for manual reposting, you'll be just taking the values from the cars cost center and repost it to the trucks. If you have posted in the vans cost center, you'd be taking from the vans cost center and repost it to the cars cost center. Or any other incorrect cost center, whatever amount you have posted, using the same cost element, you can repost it to another cost center. Similarly, this can be done for internal orders and other CEO objects as well. This is called reposting or manual reposting in the CEO module. And SAP facilitates this via a transaction code. So let's look at the difference between reposting and allocation. As I mentioned earlier, incorrect postings can be corrected by doing the reposting transactions, and these costs should be reposted with the original cost element. So if you have used a salary expense GL account and you have created this as a primary cost element for a salary expense cost element, you must use the same account to do the reposting. You should not use a different cost element. Let's look at the difference between reposting and allocation. In reposting, what you're going to do is you're going to, the original debit amount from the sender is going to be reduced. So for example, in this cost center 10101 facilities management, you have posted the entry with the GL account 501000, which is also your primary cost element, rental expenses, you posted a debit entry of $5,000. Now when you're reposting it, what will happen is there will be a credit entry posted here and this amount will be disappearing from the reports. So after doing the reposting report, you'll be seeing there won't be any entries in this section under this particular cost center because you're taking the value away from here and posting this to the correct cost center, another cost center. But in allocation, as we've seen earlier in some of our presentations, what's going to happen is the original debit amount will remain intact. And at the bottom of the cost center report, you will see the credit entry coming in. Even though the net effect is zero in both the instances, whereas here the actual entries of debit and credit will be displayed. And the other cost center will have the debit entry. That's the two difference between reposting and allocation. Where reposting, the entry will be gone, and in allocation, the original entry as well as the credit entry will be there. Second thing is allocation, of course, is used during periodic cycle and it's an intended transaction where monthly you're going to allocate some amounts. Whereas reposting, you only use it very rarely or when you actually do an error. By all you have to do is within the CEO module, you can just allocate the cost from one cost center to another cost center by using the reposting transaction. Now let's look at an example of this. Now let's post a standard journal transaction. I'm going to use FB50 for this. So let me type in FB50. Specify a date over here. Put the currency, everything, information. I'm just going to say incorrect cost center. And here I'm going to specify a GL account. I'm going to use 51440s. That is a council fees expense account and a balance sheet account. This is my bank account. So I'm going to pay the council fees using my bank account. This is a debit entry and this is a credit entry. I'm just going to put amount as $1,000. also $1,000.